And there are disturbing new details tonight as the search for former Brisbane TV presenter Jesse Baird and his partner Luke Davies turns to a remote property.
Police say there was an elaborate attempt to hide their bodies and have confirmed there was a 000 call from Jesse's phone moments after gunfire was heard.
Bungonia, infamous as the suspected burial place of Sydney mother Kerry Whelan, infamous again 3 decades later. Police believe Beau Lamar Condon submerged the bodies of Jesse Baird and Luke Davies in a dam here, travelling with an acquaintance who likely had no idea why they were there.
She was left at the front gate whilst he disappeared for a period of 30 minutes.
They allegedly accessed the private property with an angle grinder bought at Bunnings in Goulburn, and investigators believe their accused might have returned solo.
Suspicious of the acquaintance that attended with him and about her beliefs of what he might have been up to, and very likely may have returned to those bodies later that evening and disposed of them somewhere else. The accused has not disclosed where Jesse and Luke are.
For the first time today, a timeline.
Thursday, February 15, Beau Lamar Condon signs out his service pistol to police a protest on Sunday. Monday, 9:50am, gunshots are heard inside Jesse Baird's Paddington Terrace. They're not reported to police. 4 minutes later, a 000 call from Jesse's phone.
Nothing said or heard, from my understanding. Very brief.
It would only become crucial on Wednesday when bloodied clothes and ID are found at Cronulla. Police head to Paddington as Lamar Condon allegedly heads to Bungonia with his acquaintance. He returns to Moore Park Supercentre. 11 p.m. he purchases weights, then returns to Bungonia, leaving there by 4:30 a.m. He then visits a friend in Newcastle, asking for a hose to clean his hired van before handing himself in the following day.
7 News can reveal that friend is former PCYC officer Renee Fortuna.
We're having a lot more families reach out to us.
She had the terrible misfortune of simply helping a mate, now unwittingly swept up in a double homicide, as police examine a celebrity hunting cop with multiple internal complaints against his name.
Our recruits are assessed by psychologists, so that will form part of the investigation.
Police are also investigating reports of a break-in at Jesse Baird's Paddington home last August, and allegations from friends Lamar Condon had been stalking his ex for months. How police guns are stored and accessed will now be reviewed by Victoria Police. Lamar Condon had allegedly signed his out for 5 days.
It's a failure if someone has used their service firearm in the manner that's alleged.
Robert Ovadia, 7 News.
Well, let's go to Leonie Ryan near Bungonia. And Leonie, have police found anything of significance there?
Sharon, police divers have been focusing on a dam directly behind the house at this property, but haven't seized any evidence as yet which would lead them to the men's bodies. But the search at Cellar Farm is far from over. We've been told the riot squad will return to continue a line search where everything from cigarette butts to empty bottles are being seized to be forensically examined. And the area they're searching is huge. The land measures 100 hectares and there are at least half a dozen dams. 7 News has spoken to the owner of the farm. He's away at the moment, but says police had contacted him and he was more than happy for them to search his property because, like the family and friends of Luke Davies and Jesse Baird, he just wants them to be found.